These rocks from the heavens aren't just beautiful. If you find one, you could be in for a payday. But the question is, who gets to keep it if it actually falls to Earth? How do you even tell it apart? And why do people keep calling it different names like asteroids or meteorites? Let's start at the beginning.
Meet this asteroid. It's been floating in space for light years. I know, quite lonely, which is why it's time for it to join us on Earth. The journey could go one of three ways. One, it misses Earth and is left to drift into space as an asteroid forever. Two, it enters Earth's atmosphere and changes into a meteor and vaporizes. We call that a shooting star. Or three, it enters, changes into a meteor, and after lighting up the sky disco style, it hits land and changes into a meteorite. But the chances of that are pretty slim. About 100 tons of rock falls to Earth every day, usually into water since most of Earth is covered by it. And if it's not that, it's usually in uninhabited places, which there's a lot of. Antarctica is usually a hotspot, funny that, because there's a whole lot of Antarctica and cold temps to keep those meteorites intact. And that's why people go on big hunting missions over there to find them.
People go down as a team and basically camp in the middle of Antarctica on the Trans-Antarctic Mountains. And we actually go through New Zealand on our way there, which is great. And we basically look on the ice for the meteorites that have been, some of them have fallen, you know, hundreds of thousands of years ago and have just been trapped in the ice, and the ice moves and they get stuck up against those mountains. And the ice eventually, you know, degrades away, leaving those meteorites sitting on the surface. So we can just go, it's like picking up a black rock on a white surface, and they're really easy to spot.
So how do you tell the difference between a meteorite and a rock from Earth? Well, there's three ways to find out. First, the rock is in a random place where a rock shouldn't be. Second, it looks like a teardrop because of the way it fell to Earth. And finally, it's magnetic. Rocks are ionized in space. After those checks, you can get it tested by a museum or geology department. All right, buddy, time to shine.